Thank you. sure you how long have you worked on it?
I started on January, but okay. I had like a huge break because I was graduating from.
Oh yeah. Okay. Great. I'm gonna take one of these chairs.
I'm gonna take that one just to
yeah. Okay. Look. There's.
I'm gonna sit up here.
It's very, very popular and very famous, and everybody likes to play it. And which means we have to play it that much better. You know, we have to have things very, very clear in our mind. And so I would like to approach this two different ways. First of all, your interpretation, your approach to the piece, your idea of the story, of the piece and the structure, your idea. And then I also wanted to some technical things that will help to make that better. So now that you played through it first, I wish I could go back. How do you really want to begin this piece? How do you see, what is the ideal way? What do you have in mind when you first start?
Well, right now I think I haven't gone through the technical parts.
That's kind of what it sounds like, you know, that maybe you haven't thought about it. That's cool. Probably, okay, so he tells us a lot. He wants it to be a march and also piano. Mm-hmm. And the tempo can be very different. I mean, Rachmaninoff played everything really fast. I mean, all of his recordings are extremely fast. And then Gilels, you know, other Russians play also very quickly. You don't have to. It can be also like you play. I like your tempo. It's more of a march tempo. So, and that's an important thing. It's a snare drum in the beginning. So we have to sort of imitate that. We have to have the drum, you have to be a good drummer. And then also the melody has to be clear and separate from the rhythm. So right now I feel like it's all connected and we need to have that separation, okay? So so how to do that? Well, first of all, have the idea. And that already will help you a lot. Let's try, why don't you start? Okay, let's just take those three bars and we'll work on it a little bit. So we want to let's try, and when you practice, you should be really picky. Now you know the notes, so now you can get very, very precise about how you want to design. Can you play the three Gs? Balanced the way you want. Yeah, way more top, right? When in doubt, it's always the top place. Okay, so that's cool. And then, now, what about your pedaling, too? I think that you use a little bit too much. And here's the thing about pedal. I was talking to Sharon about this yesterday. I love to use the pedal. I use the pedal all the time, in every music, because I think it's a very important part of our instrument. Franz Liszt said it was the soul of the piano. Yeah. The pedal is the soul of the piano. And it's true, we can't separate the soul from the body, or else we'll just have a machine. So we need to always incorporate, even in Bach, I think. But you have to be so smart, you know, you have to be very clever, and not let your pedaling interfere with the lines. Okay? And I think if you can try, how about if we play bom, and hands pretty close to the piano, and try to connect them, but don't overlap them. I don't think it should be. May I try? So we can play.
Thank you.
much. But we do have to have it in the fingers too. I believe in the pedal, but I believe in the fingers too. And so that's your assignment, I think, is to really to make sure that all of your rhythm in all four voices, cha cha cha, cha cha cha, cha cha cha. And so I think it's a very difficult beginning. I think the piece is very hard because of that. Everything has to be quite balanced. Can we go? Let's just go on a little bit further. Now here you have to use a little bit more pedal, right? But I think the first few bars we practically don't need it.
Okay.
But this is an exciting moment because it's the first long note.
Mm-hmm.
Everything before that had been short. The melody finally emerges there, and it should be a special moment. So you set the stage very, very carefully in the beginning, and then it sings. Suddenly. But the other stuff is mostly. So this kind of thinking, I would love for you to kind of go through and think about it. But let's try from the top. So rhythm in the beginning, and then the melody comes through.
Thank you.
you really want to see this, so to make that as smooth as possible. If
think it's more. And the pedal, you need to be much, much more careful.
Okay.
It's like here, for instance, yes, use the pedal. Yes, but, right? So, can I hear it slowly?
Okay. Yes.
Thank you.
attention to musical detail that you're doing here. It sounds very beautiful. I think you could work a little bit more on the left hand to make sure that it is so controlled that it doesn't interfere with what you're doing. Okay? So very smooth and you're close to the key. Try to work out so that you have a finger quite secure so you don't have to lift very often. But it's nice. And then, you know, when this voice emerges, and the other middle voice, when that happens, we need to hear it a little bit stronger, okay? But that was a nice start. Let's try it once more. I might stop. When you just really bring that, because our ear is not listening for this. We don't know that it's coming, but we do because we've heard the piece 3 million times. But we aren't expecting that. So it can be this, you know, that soloist, that baritone probably, has to really do it. He's not a tenor. Same. But he still has to be arrogant enough to bring out.
Yeah. Same here.
I think so, but this is a little bit easier. Mm-hmm. But the same principle, yes. Okay? So you have to have, in your mind, three different areas. You've got your left hand, your right hand melody up there, and then stuff in the middle. I know you know that, but you have to demonstrate it even more. Okay. Separate those things. Know those parts so well. And it takes a lot of time, you know, and a lot of work, but I think it's well worth it. Try once more. I like this tempo. Let's keep it slow. Just reminded of something else. If
Here, Richard, here. This, do you play Bach? What, do you enjoy playing Bach? Because this is a lot like Bach, right? And any voicing exercise, I have this voicing exercise.
Cristian va a tocar la balada número uno de Chopin.
Excelente.
¿Sí?
Okay. Thank you, Cristian.
Por favor, Cristian, puedes bajar el atril. Gracias.
Thank you.
Beautiful. Sometimes the tempos, yes, it has sometimes to go faster, sometimes to go slower, but I feel like it goes extremely fast, and it's also, you know, a little bit too hard to play, if you play too fast. So maybe keep all the tactics a little bit, in, not to get too excited, but it's difficult with this, because we get emotionally involved in the underneath, and we want to go, and you go faster and faster. And especially, you know, my teacher used to write in, you know, things just like that, you know. Más rápido, you know. And the thing that, when our teacher writes something, we do it. And then we do it for a week, we do it for 2 weeks, and it still says, más rápido, más rápido. So we keep speeding up, you know. So I think you got rápido, rápido enough. And then maybe phrase it a little bit more. So I think sometimes your tempos go a little bit too fast, and then other times it comes a little bit too slow. And I'll tell you one place I'm thinking about, and then we'll go one more. Let me ask you about this. After all of this music, we have this, right? We have a rhythm, right? Like the beginning. But is it like the beginning exactly? Yeah, tempo. Well, you know, whenever we have music that comes back at the end, it returns. There's something different about it. Yeah, it's not exactly the same as what you heard in the beginning. So sonatas, you know, you have the first theme in the sonata, and then you have the whole exposition and the development section, and then the first theme comes back again. It's not exactly the same character now, because it has lived a whole life, and it's different. Yeah, harmony, basically it's the same. It's quite similar, although, yeah, we now have this bass note, which is different. But it is meno-moso, but after all of this fast stuff, you play so slow, it comes back to zero. But it sounds a little bit, it doesn't fit. You know, it doesn't have not quite the right pair. It needs to, this is different from the beginning. The beginning is more relaxed. This one is not relaxed. There's tension. Because this, yes, there's tension. And I feel like you didn't have much tension. Please keep that underlying me. Which means the tempo also, and also the how you phrase this, needs to be a little bit more forward. Not like, it's fine. Okay, so those are two examples of what I'm talking about with the tempo, that maybe just to think about tempo in general, all right? So that your story, again, the shape of your whole performance is logical. Okay, so that's general. Let's do some real work now. You can play the piano. In the beginning, let's start. Now look. You play this actually quite beautifully. Think about, the first note is very dramatic, but it is also related to this, right? This phrase is part of this. Please. don't make it sound separate, you know. Okay. This note is loud. This one is not piano, right? It's it needs to connect, right? Let's make that loud.
Thank you.
becomes actually easier after that. But this is the difficult one, because you have, this is where you have to, I think you understand the idea. Now you have to play it a few more times when you're practicing, and also figure out how to put rubato that makes sense, that helps you make your story. I have an idea how I would do it, but I don't know that you would do it. Like, for instance, each one of these doesn't have to start exactly the same way. Sometimes, maybe the first one can be maybe later you. So, depending on the story, I kind of think this one would be stretched out a little bit. Because, but anyway, so that's what I'm looking to think about this stuff. This is great. You're faster.
Yeah.
I mean, you can play it. It's just maybe you can pass right now. Because I don't feel a shape. I feel like, oh, hold on, it has to be really, really fast. But maybe let's get into that a little bit. Let's do it from here. I don't want to hear you play this. So many different things, and it can be very beautiful. I would love for you to be a little bit more careful. So, and pay attention to this stuff. And it's hard to shape that. I think you spend a lot of time there. Let me do that once, actually. Can you shape it even better? You can use pedal, of course, but just like that. Just like that.
Together.
Okay, good. Keep going. Okay, so maybe when you play it this first time, think about that. Tampo ping, this is an important event. And then, and you should voice it. I don't know what this says, but it probably says it. Voice the top, right? The top one. Ki ho ki, because that becomes more important here. Okay, so you have ta ho ki, ho ki, ho ki, ho ki. This one is different. This is not one of these. This is a different instrument. And it should sound so. Right? Let's take one more time.
Thank you.
Yeah, the rhythm is terribly important for you. That was nice.
Thank you.
when you slowly go, only the D. Only the E, not the E. You know, so make sure the pedal is nice and clear. Can you do it once more from this way? Very important. My teachers used to talk about the
You're a very sensitive musician and a very beautiful singer on the piano. That's great. We need that. We need that for everything. And,
yes.
No, that's very important. You have a very good ability to sing, which it's very, very necessary. Most of the time, it's very, very beautiful. You have a couple of things that I want to address. When you play the melody and you sing so carefully, be sure not to hold notes that you shouldn't. Like when you play here, can you play for me? This line. You can use both hands. I hear it because your playing is so beautiful, and then when I hear good though, that's nice. And the other thing, listen very careful to your pedaling. It was already better the second time, but make sure that your pedal change is clear, okay? Always. Can we start? Just the right hand. perfect, but without the pedals available. It will sound even better if you okay. This is similar to other lessons I need. And then yeah, some more of those. Okay, so that's all I have to say about this part. This is nice, I like it. Your pedaling is simple. I wonder if maybe it's too simple. Can I hear you play the G major part?
Thank you.
You have, what do you have to control? You have your feet, you can change, but you also have voicing, how you distribute the voices and where you put emphasis. In this case, top note and hold that, and then pedal with that, and then this one is light, and then it sounds like you're pedaling all the way, all the time. Yeah. It's, that's what will help you, I think. Yeah, nice, that was good too. Can I hear from here to the end? Well, no.
Okay, the coda, that's the other one.
have. Thanks so much. Appreciate it.